meter ski jumping going into the second round. Here are your standings. You notice that Nukkonen of Finland and Weissflog of East Germany, big leads over everybody else, dropping all the way back to Bauer. Bauer is almost 6 points back of the number two man, Weissflog. Berg of Norway and Fios of Poland. Dennis McGrane is six. Jeff Hastings, 15. Landis Arnold, 24. And Mike Holland, 29. And Jay Rand, there were some disappointments to me in this first round of the jumping because I expected Bula of Canada to do well, Kogler of Austria, Bergerud of Norway, and, of course, Ulaga of Yugoslavia is dead last.
There were an awful lot of disappointing jumps, I'm sure, to the competitors, especially to somebody like Ulaga. He's jumping in front of a hometown crowd like this, and it's just got to be devastating. The 220-pound flyers, Weissflog and Nikkanen, sure put on a great performance that first round, and I think it's going to be a duel yet here. It's going to be a great second round.
That's incredible. Two 120-pounders are so far ahead, it's remarkable. Now, there's a tailwind, and it looks like that tailwind is going to stay behind them.
Well, what a tailwind does, it causes a little effect where your skis don't come up quite so quickly. So the air's a little tricky, but those two guys really contended well with it, and I think it bothered quite a few of the others.
It's hard to know exactly how many people have been here through the first day of jumping, 70 meters, but it's a big crowd all brought up on the mountain in buses.
The snow has started to fall. The light, not much of it. The lights are on the in run. There is a wind. It appears to be a tailwind. It moves around a lot, but it's mostly a tailwind as number 23, Dennis McGrane from Littleton, Colorado, stands in. Number six in the standings, 2.1 points from third place, 11.5 points behind Matti Nukkanen of Finland. His first Olympics. Looks relaxed. At least he's trying to sell himself that he's relaxed and ready, and he's on his way. And
this is a big one for Dennis. It appears that he's going a little short, landed around the blue line.
Not happy with it.
Very disappointed, Dennis. Very disappointed.
Only 73 meters on the second jump for Dennis McGrane.
And that just goes to show that inexperience in a psychological situation like that with a great deal of pressure, it really is a tremendous thing to do here.
Just 21 years of age, he needs some more seasoning perhaps.
In another 4 years he'll be par. Here he is right here. He appears that he jumped a little bit up and he took the air, took too much in, and he just lost his tips and came down just way too soon.
He finishes with 178.4 points. Rolf Agiberg of Norway, who is just 0.6 of a point out of the medal range behind Bauer in third place. There isn't a lad in all of Norway who doesn't know something of the legend of Bergerud, one of the great heroes in Norwegian sport. Most interesting man. Let's listen to the story of the great Bergerud. Is the land of the midnight sun, snow and ice, where skiing was born, and where local ski jumps abound like little league diamonds across the country. This man, Bergerud, is a hero here, the greatest ski jumper in Olympic history. He lives just outside Oslo. He's 72 years of age now, rugged and healthy, with a twinkle in his eye and a spring in his step. He still has that great joy for sailing through the air. Bergerud is not only a sports star across Norway, but somewhat of a war hero as well. It was 52 years ago that he started writing his personal legend. 1932, Lake Placid, New York. Bergerud wins his first Olympic gold medal. It is just the beginning at 21 years of age. He was the world champion 1931-35, and 1936 at Garmisch-Rude becomes the only Olympian in history to successfully defend a ski jumping gold. But in 1936, Rude also competed in alpine skiing, finishing first in downhill, fourth overall. And just prior to the games, he set a world distance record of 92 meters at Planica, Yugoslavia. At these games in Germany, Chancellor Adolf Hitler watched over the activities, congratulating athletes, imposing his presence, and the world watched with dread as the threat of World War grew. 4 years later, Hitler invaded Norway. Rude refuses to participate in athletics for Nazi Germany, and he becomes a prisoner of war.
I'd been working in Germany in the 30s, and I was very popular there. So the Germans now looked upon me as a possible propaganda weapon among the athletic youth of Norway for things I didn't believe in. But I refused, saying I'd never do it.
Rude's political posture was an inspiration to other athletes. He never did compete for the Germans. He was released after being held a year longer than the other imprisoned athletes, and going home to his family, oh, he still had the fire, still had the desire to compete. Despite two Olympic golds, he came back in 1948 at St. Moritz at the age of 36, won a silver.
Even though I ended up second, the Olympic Games that I am most fond of have to be those in 1948. You know, the older you get, the harder you must train. And at that time, I really trained much harder than when I was younger.
Today, Birger Rude lives just a few miles from where he was imprisoned during World War II. Sturdy and active, he still skis some, but most of his time is given to another love.
Imagine walking around in the woods, seeing a tree that you will cut down and cut apart, trimming its branches, smelling its tar inside, transporting it home, ridding its bark, and turning it into a bench. All of that is to me the greatest joy.
Birger Rude, still an inspiration for the people of his country. Ralph Hageberg, number 31, relatively new to the Norwegian team. It's a very strong team with a lot of young people. And he is very prominent in the Norwegian plans to restore their prominence and prestige to jumping. They were dominant for so long. They've been down for a while. Third place easily within his grasp. Kind of interesting that the coach of the Norwegian team is Ludvig Zeisch of Yugoslavia. And one of his proteges is on his way.
Twisted in the air, but it's long. It could put him in contention.
He was just 6/10 of a point out of third place. Of course, Andreas Bauer is yet to jump. 86 and a half meters for Rolf Augeberg. Gives him a total of 208.5 points.
The timing appeared good. Right there, he's in a beautiful position. He rolls it over, gets parallel with the skis. Could have even have gone a little bit further, I think. Went into his landing too soon.
With that jump, he moves into second place.
I would imagine the old glue iron is flowing. I know they got cold feet because the temperature's down into the 20s now. This is Jari Puikkanen, 24 years of age, tall, 5'10", 150-pounder. Bronze medalist at 90 meters, 1980 Lake Placid, 16th in 70 meters.
Kicked out hard. Looks like he's got good speed. Beautiful takeoff. He's really maintaining air velocity. That is down there. That's one of the best jumps of the day, if not the best.
Stylish, too. 89 meters for Puikkanen. 117.4 points. That will give him a total of 212.8, and his name will flash at the top of the scoreboard, and the finish flags are flying again.